Think about panic attacks, John. When people have a panic attack, they often feel like they are dying. That is what's so ironic about it. They wrongly attribute their panic attack to a heart attack.
Yes.
Because actually, that is what's going on for them. They are so afraid of something specific in the world that they get this heart flutter and this tachycardia and this breathlessness, which mimics the heart attack and the sense of I'm falling into nothingness. Everything is disappearing from under me. I cannot make sense of any of it anymore. I'm forlorn. I'm out of my depth. Here I go into the darkness. That is a kind of dying too.
Yes, and so meaningful. And like, I think as a therapist, not like often the client comes feeling shameful that they're not having a heart attack, and like that, they can also almost miss the meaning behind what pushed them there.
Yes, and there's no shame in these things.
Yeah.
On the contrary. These are experiences that deepen us. And if there are people who never have these experiences, who are just coping at the surface of life all the time, they're likely to get a much stronger experience later on. I mean, this is how we're constituted. You know, we're constituted to sort of make things work at the surface, or to encounter a crisis or adversity or something that shakes us. And then we plunge and we go deeper. And when we plunge and we go deeper into that death zone, into that nothingness, into that darkness, what do, John? It's like we get planted in the earth and we shoot down roots. Mm-hmm. It's only in the darkness that we shoot down roots. And we need those roots if we're going to flourish and create all these branches and make all these new leaves and enjoy our lives.
Yeah.
We cannot do one without the other. Otherwise, we remain at the surface. So far from there being shame in these crises or these difficulties, it is our learning. It is where we open up. It is where we discover things that we never even thought were possible. And how wonderful is that?
So wonderful, Emmy. Yes, like those moments are real opportunities for us. Yeah. Yeah.
But, you know, there's no point in just saying that, is it? We got to really discover why it is an opportunity, how it is an opportunity. I don't want to sort of teach people to go out to their clients and sit there with them and say, okay, cool, that's fine. You're having a really hard time. You are now really learning something, you know, this is good for you. That's the worst possible way to be encountered when you're really in the great and narrow place and things are really that low and that hard for you.
Yeah. So what's the capacity, Emmy, you know, like as practitioners, what is the muscle we need to be strengthening to be useful in that moment?
Yeah, you got it there in one, John. Absolutely.